issues?
I do. I like to give just a little snapshot of what went on and, you know, maybe even quote some of the people that were down there testifying. And if I'm in a committee hearing or if I'm on the floor, some of the representatives and what they have to say on both sides of the aisle, I like to give a real picture of what's gone on, and then I like to say, and this is what I would have done. So people can really know. Because I think the problem with our government right now is there are so many people in office that can't be trusted. They'll say one to one person, mm-hmm. I'm pro-life, to the next person, I'm pro-choice. They look at who are they talking to and what's... I have these certain beliefs, and I'm going to believe them no matter what you think, because this is who I am, and this is what you're going to get. So I want to be really upfront with that, that these are the things I believe in.
I think that's really important, because, and that's why I asked you to throw your website out there again, because so many of the candidates, if you go to their website, it doesn't say anything. Mm-hmm. It says, oh, I really support clean water and clean air. Well, who doesn't?
Right, exactly.
I really want to keep the spending down. Well, who doesn't?
Right.
And you can, they just don't tell you which side of the aisle they fall on. Mm-hmm. Candidates like you mm-hmm. are, you throw it out there. You mm-hmm. may not agree with everything right. that you say, or what I'm going to bet is more people will agree than they even thought so.
Yeah.
And they'll be able to get behind you too, but you actually know where you stand. You're right. not afraid to say, you know what, the spending in Minnesota is out of control. We can talk about the bonding budget. Mm. There are already $2.5 billion in bonding requests for the state of Minnesota. Did they miss the memo? We're broke?
Mm-hmm. Right.
I think they must have.
Right. Even in my little community of Lake Elmo, they're talking about $1 million bike path. And I'm saying to my mayor, this is the worst economy of our lifetime. Why would you do that right now? You're right. People aren't really understanding that. Dire situation that we're in. We're in a dire situation. And I'll just say too, when I ran last time, I had a yard sign in a yard. I talked to a woman for a long time. She was all about my campaign, and the next time I came by, it was gone. And I thought, well, maybe it got stolen or something. So I went to her door, and she said, I'm really sorry, Kathy, but I didn't know that you were not pro-choice. So I had to take your sign down. And I said, well, you know, let's talk about this a little bit. I'm just going to tell you I'm pro-life, and this is what I believe. And she said, yeah. And I'm like, okay, well, thanks anyway. You know, it was really nice knowing you. So, I mean, my opponent, on the other hand, sometimes will say one thing and to one person and the opposite to the other person. So
the integrity, it's one of those things. It absolutely amazes me. Politics is not always a clean business.
No, it isn't. But I like to bring some clean.
Yes.
Into the game.
Right. So. And you hear frequently that... let's see. Mark Twain was quoted as, nobody's safe when the legislator's in session. Mm-hmm. I love that one. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And then you hear the line about making laws is like making sausage, it isn't pretty. Mm-hmm. Well, no, it is definitely not pretty. Mm-hmm. But far too often you're seeing people reach across the aisle, and all it does was hurt our liberties and mm-hmm. our freedoms. Mm-hmm. And it would be nice to have someone strong enough to stand mm-hmm. up and mm-hmm. say, wait a minute, stop. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Let's wrap up with jobs and the economy again, because I think this is so important. Mm-hmm. And obviously, from all your having visited with the small businesses in your area, you understand that Minnesota can't continue to be a business-unfriendly community. Mm-hmm. And the lower taxes and the less regulations are key. Mm-hmm. And what else do you think that the small businesses or the people in your area are going to want to see changed?
Well, I think that they just need a handle on these taxes, and they need, you know, unemployment taxes are out of control, and one woman that I talked to yesterday named about four other taxes that all had acronyms on them that I can't even keep in my head right now, because there's just so many layers on these people that she said they can't even bid a job where they can make any money right now. They have to bid jobs under budget to get work for their business, so... You know, we just need to get a handle on all of these different things. And I want to talk about healthcare a little bit, because even before we had the whole Washington healthcare, we had Minnesota wanting to have a constitutional amendment to say that the residents of Minnesota would have a right to healthcare. And that would mean anybody that lived here for 30 days would have a right to a single-payer healthcare system. And, you know, we have problems with healthcare, you might say, but they have more to do with the government getting involved mm-hmm. than not getting involved. Mm-hmm. And, you know, just the 63 mandates, I think it is. 68 mandates on insurance companies. You know, I have a son that's 22 years old. He needs to buy his own health insurance. He doesn't need pregnancy coverage. He doesn't need chemical dependency, all these things that are mandated on him, so therefore he can't afford insurance. And I think we need to have a system where, just for example, I have a son who has a disability. He's had over 60 surgeries. In the early days of his life, he's 28 now, we used to get the bills when he went in for surgery, and we could look at them and, oh, they charged us for a blood transfusion. Well, he didn't have a blood transfusion. They charged us for two,
1 minute.
If he had an artificial something or whatever. But, you know, he only has one of those. So we don't have that anymore. In the last 10 years, you just get your bill at the end of the day. The insurance company goes back and forth with the hospital. You don't have, there's no accountability to mm-hmm. anything. Mm-hmm. I think we need to go back to that, where we can look at these bills, we can see what we're, and just some competition. You should be able to call up your physician. How much does it cost to have your knee arthroscoped or something? And people need to know what they're paying for, but it's just like, oh, well, insurance company's going to pay for it. Let's have an MRI. Let's have this. Let's have everything. There's a lot of things that we could do, I think, to cut the costs in insurance that would bring the patient and the doctor more together.
Exactly, and it's so important that we the people retain control, mm-hmm. not government control. Mm-hmm. All right, I want to thank you so much, Kathy Lohmer, for running for office. We need more candidates like you.
Thank you.
It's it'll be a great honor to watch you get sworn in.
Oh, thanks, Sue. Thank you. And thanks for all that you do, again, for being out there for us, being on the radio, and educating all of us, because you're out there and you're at the Capitol and you're on the radio, you're telling everyone, and we really appreciate all that you do, too. So
thank you. 2010 is going to be a blast. Thank you.